Our model can give us some insight about what might happen, but there are some limitations and assumptions as we have seen before. How can we make the model better? We have included the death rate as 3.4%. But we see that the death rate varies depending on your age. Perhaps one way we can improve our model is to stratify the population of the country we're modeling into different age groups. For that, we'll need a contact matrix instead of a single contact parameter. This is called the WAIFW matrix, short for Who Acquires Infection From Whom. The WAIFW matrix is more realistic because school children tend to contact each other a lot, while the elderly do not contact people as much. Check out the resources in the video description for more information. We can also try and model populations at the global scale instead of picking a certain country. Then we can see what the effects of closing airports and seaports can have. These are only a few suggestions to improve the model. There are many more ways that we can probably think of. In our simulation, we showed that the early policy effects can save more than 10 million lives in Russia. Though this may not be realistic, it can still give us a sense of how large the benefits of locking down cities or banning travel can have. These estimates could help governments make important decisions at the international level. For those of you who just wanted a simple introduction into disease modeling, I hope that this gave you a taste of the branch of mathematics called epidemiology. And for those of you who are interested in the technical details, I'll go over the code in the next video.